These papers were supposed to be on my desk yesterday.
What papers?
The papers that I assigned you.
The papers you assigned Greg?
Greg is out. He's on vacation because he's a good employee.
Yeah, it's a good point. It's a good point. So, papers. These are.
I need these. I have to go pick up my daughter's prom dress. It's a big night for her. Not a big night for you. You should be here.
Prom, yeah. You know, did I ever tell you about my prom story, Randall?
No.
I don't care. It all started. I was a sophomore, and Stacey Stevens was. I mean, she was the it girl of the junior class, and she had just broken up with her boyfriend Trent. And I mean, there I was, a sophomore, and her a junior. You know, I figured she's a free agent the week before prom. I mean, here's my chance. You know.
We get it. You lived happily ever after. No one cares.
You've seen my life. Do you really think I lived happily ever after that? I did something I'm not too proud of, and it kind of hurt a friend of mine, and it kind of ruined my entire life. I told Stacy that, you know, this girl Roxy, I was really close with her, that she had gotten a nose job, and that's why she missed school for 2 weeks. She just had the flu. But Stacy went and told everyone in my high school that she had gotten a nose job, and her new name was Nose Job Janetti.
Okay, we get it. You peaked in high school. I don't care. Do your work.
Yeah, I really regret it, you know, looking back at that whole thing. I mean, we're never really friends again, and, you know, Stacy went with Brock Jackson, and I mean, I was all alone on prom night. I wonder what she's up to right now. She's probably doing better than me. I mean, dead-end job and all alone at 40. And I guess I could do these papers. Crandall? Crandall. Where's Crandall at? Who are you? What are you wearing?
Tomothy, I am the Yerba Sage. I know you're a man filled with regret. I'm here to give you a second chance on life. In my left hand, I have orange exuberance. It will take you forward in time, deeper into the misery you've made for yourself. In my right hand, blue for you. This will take you back to high school where you'll have a chance to right your wrongs. Can you accept this responsibility?
I guess. I mean, that sounds...
But you mustn't tell anyone who you are, especially not your younger self if you run into him. You'll break and shatter the dimensions of time and destroy the world as we know it.
That's a lot of rules. Sure. Whoa. Is this my high school? What am I doing here?
Hey, kid, get to class.
Sure. Class.
Now!
Okay, I'm going. Hey, how's it going, man?
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. I'm Rufus. Rufus T. Crandall.
Okay.
How's it going, man?
Shaking my hand.
Well, yeah, that's you meet somebody, you shake their hand.
Not when you're in the bathroom, you don't. I haven't even washed yet.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah, for you.
You want a lick?
No. Why would I take a lick of your dum-dum that you just had in the bathroom? Why do you have a dum-dum in the bathroom?
Oh, you know, sometimes you have a dum-dum in the bathroom. I mean,
nope.
That's not that.
That's just a you thing, pal.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm very sure.
Hey,
I've never had a dum-dum.
What if we go grab a soda after school today? You want to go hang out?
No, I don't want to go with a soda with you after school, Rufus. I'm sure the cup holders are very nice, but no, I don't want to. I'm going to go. I might see you around. That might not, too. But yeah, no, I'm out of here.
Hey, man, I'll see you around or something.
Really fucked that up.
You're telling me.
Not again.
Howdy there, boys. My name's Rufus T. Crandall, just low into town looking to find me a sarsaparilla.
Howdy there, Carter.
Where from? Who?
I'm from Finland.
Who is this guy?
He's Rufus T. Crandall. Here to introduce himself.
Yeah, this guy looks like he's a 40-year-old man. What is he doing in our classroom?
I don't know. He looks about.
I'm only about 16, sir.
What are you guys talking about? He has gray chest hairs. What is he doing? We're in a math class.
Yeah, maybe he's a super senior.
You seem upset there, partner.
I'm very upset. You're a 40-year-old man in my math class. I don't understand what's going on. Why are you friends with him?
Rufus T. Crandall.
I don't understand what's going on.
My daddy was Randall T. Crandall.
Get out of my class.
Anyways, boys. It was mighty nice to meet you all. here this afternoon, but I do have to get going. So, mosey on out of town, and I'll be back later.
What are you, Major Rubes? Oh, my goodness, Rubes, it seems to be time to start the education.
I
do declare I spy a fine little lady over in yonder direction.
Then the name of that lass over there?
I believe that would be Stacy, the newly single Stacy, that is.
Newly single, she does not have a cowboy.
No, Trent, the feller sitting behind her in the hat and the large fur coat, recently separated from her.
Oh, well, you know what they say about a cowgirl without a horse?
I don't, I'm going to be honest with you. But she should find a cowboy. And I plan to be said cowboy.
Oh, why do you find yourself wanting to be the cowboy of that cowgirl?
Well, I intend to go over yonder, maybe spin a little yarn about a certain somebody getting a certain nasal procedure, and then,
You can't be speaking about young Roxy.
I certainly can.
Ugh, that's a terrible idea, sir.
Listen, if it's a terrible idea, I'll go through with it and face the consequences.
Ugh, you can't be doing this.
You again.
What's going on?
Well, you've managed to fix things with your younger self, but he still wants to go spread some rumors about Roxy.
How do you suppose I fix this?
You're not taking this seriously enough. I gave you a second chance at life, and you're coming back here messing around.
Yeah, you're right.
Do you even care about her?
I don't think it dawned on me how serious this really screwed up my life, this whole sequence of events, and now I'm just looking at my younger self, and what an idiot I was.
You lost a best friend and someone you really could have had a great life with.
You're right.
I only have so much of this. Don't fuck up this time.
Hey, this might be like the worst possible time to bring this up, but I don't think you should be saying all this stuff about Roxy, especially to Stacy.
Dude, this is quite literally the worst time to bring that up because there's a killer right down there. But I think you're right. I'm probably not gonna say the stuff about Roxy.
Dude, glad to hear it.
Yeah, no.
So you're gonna ask Roxy out?
No, dude, I'm still gonna ask Stacy out for sure.
God damn it!
Dude, I think honestly it would be best if we split up.
Yeah.
It's harder to find one of us in two places than two of us in one place.
You are so right, man.
Yeah. I'm great at math. All right, on three. One,
three,
two,
one.
Let's go.
Oh, God, it's you again?
Closer, but not quite.
Oh, God, what am I gonna do?
He still wants to talk to Stacy. Try something else. But you need to hurry because he's coming.
Jesus.
He'll go away as soon as you go somewhere else.
Well, seems my boy's got you in a bit of a bind here.
You did this to me?
Oh, you know I did.
Why? Why do you have me here?
You keep lying, saying you like Stacy. They don't have feelings for Roxy, and I know you do.
That's not the truth. You know it. You know it. Ah! That's not the way
it is.
Oh,
yes, it is. You like Roxy, see? And you just gotta admit it to me, son, and this whole thing can stop.
All right. It's fine. It's true.
You need to ask her to prom now, you see?
I can't do that. You know I can't. Ah! You know I can't do it!
You're gonna do it!
No!
Give me the brick, boys.
No, please, no. No, it's just, what if it doesn't work out? What if I lose a friend? I can't do it, I'm too scared.
You're gonna do it.
No, no!
How was that?
Are you kidding me right now?
What?
He's a bloody mess in there. You didn't get anything out of him.
Now
he can't go to prom with anyone.
Is that wrong? Well, should I not have done that?
No, you shouldn't have done that.
Okay. Hey, so how come I never see you drinking any of this stuff?
Okay.
Is that what happens when you drink too much of that?
Yeah, you deserve that one. I've never had a client actually have to drink so much that they throw it up.
Okay. So, really gonna do it?
Yeah, this isn't really.
You're asking Roxy to prom?
Sure am.
I'm glad you're doing this, man. This is the right decision.
Thanks, you really, you showed me the way on this one.
Hey, least I can do.
Thanks, if she comes in this area, you just gotta get her, like, right here.
You got it.
Got a whole deal planned out.
Go get him, Tiger.
Thanks.
Hey, Roxy, what's going on?
Where are you?
Yeah, I'm new in town. I just moved here from Finland. Anyway, I think Tom has something good there.
I was wrong. It was you. It was always you. And I didn't know that until now. But now I do. Will you go to prom with me?
Tom, that song? Well, it was terrible. And now everybody's watching us. And I'm very uncomfortable. It's like you don't even know me. I'm just gonna go.
Getting closer. Closer, it's still not working. I've tried everything. We went to the Old West. There was a musical. I mean, we've done absolutely everything, and I just don't. Oh, hey, what's up? You get it? You don't understand what's going on anymore?
I've never seen either of you so open with your emotions before. I can tell you're getting close.
How close?
I don't know. It's up to you this time.
Yes, I understand. We need that information, yes. Спасибо, я.
You wanna tell me what the hell this is?
I need the information, otherwise I will kill-
Oh my god!
Oh my god.
Let's get her.
Oh wait, hold on, before you do that.
What?
This is for Roxy, don't lose it.
Really, what?
She's gonna love it, she's gonna love it.
Okay, let's untie the hostage.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, okay. No, I get that.
Oh my god. Thank you.
No problem.
You're just really freaking me out there. Coat and everything?
Yeah, it's too warm out for that kind of coat. Let's get out of here.
Hey.
See you homecoming.
Where are you? And I'm so sorry. I cannot sleep. I cannot dream tonight.
I got you this.
What is it?
It's music. It's.
Yeah, but I've never heard anything like it before.
Yeah, no, it's gonna be huge soon. It's called pop punk, actually. Yeah, sure.
So, why are you giving this to me?
Well, I fucked up, and I don't just want to be friends. So, do you want to go to prom with me?
Yeah.
Hey man, I just wanted to say, thanks so much for all your help. You sorted a lot of stuff out.
It's what I do, you know?
Yeah.
Listen, it was great getting to know you and all, but
yeah,
I gotta go
too.
Back to Finland. It was just this temporary
really?
Business trip with my old man, so.
You missed it. You helped me out a lot. Thank you.
No problem, man. Have a good night.
You too.
You again.
Nice work,
Bobby. Hey, you know? Anything for me.
Sounds about right. Ready to hit that home?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's go. By the way, is my tongue turning blue a side effect of all these yerbas?
One of them.
Hey, here's that rough cut that you asked for, Mr. Barbito.
Thank you so much, Crandall.
Hey, look.
It's rough cut, your first official release. It's gonna be out 3-4 weeks, maybe?
Yeah, it's definitely a surreal moment. But it's all thanks to that first cassette you gave me in sophomore year.
It was really something special, huh?
Yeah. Listen, yeah, I know you're fucking Crandall.